Welcome to the great Exodus series, God's plan of rescue for his children. Let my people go, the path to Mount Zion. Today, in our topic, we will talk about Micah, the remnant at Mount Zion. My name is Michael. I'm the founder of Triple Grace and the Righteous Path Movement Foundation. Please watch all of our videos in our YouTube channel and try to support the case of Baby Grace by becoming a sponsor. We have an extra video for that also on the YouTube channel uploaded today. If you're guided, please sow into the ministry to help us to spread the video and the messages and the teaching to all the people in the world. Now let us start with our teaching about Micah. Micah's prophecy summarizes the remnant's events in four phases. Note, the prophet Micah's prophecy has never been fulfilled. Jesus treading his high places. Micah 1, we read, "Hear, you peoples, all of you, pay attention, O earth, and all that is in it, and let the Lord God be a witness against you, the Lord from his holy temple. For behold, the Lord is coming out of his place, and will come down and tread upon the high places of the earth." This is exactly what we are preaching and teaching since the start of the ministry of Triple Grace. Mount Zion is coming down onto the earth at the sixth seal. Let's continue. 1. The remnant is gathered into a sheepfold to meet Jesus before darkness starts, before trumpets. Micah 2. "I will surely assemble all of you, O Jacob. I will gather the remnant of Israel. And this, my beloved brothers, are you, the remnant of Israel. I will set them together like sheep in a fold, like a flock in its pasture, a noisy multitude of men." Where do we see the multitude? In the sixth seal in the book of Revelation, the multitude clothed in white. A group that nobody can number. "He who opens the breach goes up before them. They break through and pass the gate, going out by it. Their king passes on before them, and the Lord at their head." Then the peace declaration and darkness comes in Micah 3. "Thus says the Lord concerning the prophets who lead my people astray, who cry peace when they have something to eat, but declare war against him who puts nothing into their mouths. Therefore it shall be night to you without vision, and darkness to you without divination. The sun shall go down on the prophets, and the day shall be black for over them." You see, that is a time of trumpets. But we also see then the remnant will go up to Mount Zion for training. Micah 4. "It shall come to pass in the latter days that the mountain of the house of the Lord, Zion, shall be established as the highest of the mountains, and this is on earth, and it shall be lifted up above the hills, and people shall flow to it, and many nations shall come and say, come, let us go up to the mountain of the Lord, to the house of the God of Jacob, that he may teach and train us his ways, and they may walk in his paths." This is also the training of the 144,000 who will go out into the nations when Satan will come down. 3. The remnant of lame, blind, and innocent are taken to the heavenly Mount Zion. It is a heavenly Mount Zion, but it is on earth established. Micah 4. "In that day, declares the Lord, I will assemble the lame and gather those who have been driven away and those whom I have afflicted. All you people who have gone through tribulations and all the people who are suffering, they are coming now. And the lame I will make the remnant, and those who were cast off a strong nation. And the Lord will reign over them in Mount Zion from this time forth forevermore. They will enter paradise in the rapture, as I have always told you. At the sixth seal, Micah has all the prophecies about the remnant, about Mount Zion, and about coming together as a multitude and be raptured, what we see in the sixth seal. For the remnant sent back to work the harvest when the Assyrian, here said Antichrist, but it's not Assyrian, is Satan, takes over. Micah 5. When the Assyrian comes into our land and treats in our palaces, then we will raise against him 7 shepherds and 8 princes of men. They shall shepherd the land of Assyria with a sword, the land of Nimrod at its entrances. And he, Jesus, shall deliver us from the Assyrian when he comes into our land and treads within our border. And then you see in verse 7, then the remnant of Jacob shall be sent back into the midst of many people, the 144,000, the midst of many people like dew from the Lord, like showers on the grass, which delay not for a man, nor wait for the children of men. And the remnant of Jacob shall be among the nations in the midst of many peoples, like a lion among the beasts of the forest, like a young lion among the flocks of sheep, which when it goes through, treads down and tears in pieces, and there is none to deliver. This is Micah explaining the coming down of Mount Zion, the collecting of the remnants, the training of the 144,000, and the sending out of the 144,000 into the nations during the trumpet period, and also it explains the rapture into paradise to be with Jesus forever and ever at the sixth seal at Mount Zion. Now, you must understand that if we see Micah, we have a witness from the Lord, from God, that has given us for a long time to see that everything what we preach and teach is true, that Mount Zion will come down at the sixth seal, and that the 144,000 will be sealed, and the multitude closed and white will go into the rapture. Read Micah in completion, read the whole book of Micah, and you will find that everything what I'm telling you is true. So let us come out in the great exodus. First spiritually, by removing ourselves from the world, from its temptation, and from Babylon. And then later physically, when we will be collected by the angels from all of our societies of the rose in all the world, and will be brought to the base of Mount Zion, when Mount Zion has come down, in a similar pattern to what happened at Mount Sinai. And then we will enter that thick darkness, the secret place of the Lord, and there a gate will be opened for us to enter paradise. And the cherubim will step aside because we are clothed in fine white linen, because we have made our dirty garment clean in the blood of the Lamb. Micah is our witness that everything what we teach is true, and the truth will set us free. Thank you that you have listened to this topic about Micah, the remnant, the 144,000, and Mount Zion. Please support our ministry when you can. Help us to bring the message to the world, to establish societies of the rose, and to gather the people together with the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit. I love you all so dearly. Thank you, my brothers, for your help and your support. Thank you that you come together in love, unity, and support. If you have any question, please send them to triplegrace55@gmail.com, and I will answer them right away. Spread the messages about the Great Exodus. Spread the message about the sixth seal, about Mount Zion coming down. And spread the message about our ministry, so that the people will gather together, and that we come together in brotherly love and in unity, all over the world, in all the nations and in all towns, so that we can be set apart from the world and from Babylon, and become the chosen people of the Lord. the remnant of Israel, ready to be taken to Mount Zion to be raptured. Thank you. I hope you like this topic and I will see you again tomorrow. May God bless you and your family abundantly. Have a great day. Maranatha.